Like, I think I'm gonna be bringing a lot of tactics into Football Manager 2017 on Arsenal Euro 2016 under Lars Lagerbäck and Heimir Guðjónsson, and how they got through to the quarterfinals in the first ever major tournament in Icelandic history. Now, let's see how we did. Right, as you can see, I've set up a 4-4-2 shape, kind of a 4-1-1, a variation of a 4-4-2, 4-1-1, 4-4-1-1, sorry, and a 4-2-3-1. As you can see, I've done nothing fancy with the centre backs, just central defenders on defense duty. And put Sigurðsson as a full-back support because he doesn't attack as much as Skallason. Skallason loves to attack and burst forward and go up and down the flank and put crosses in for Sigurðsson. Right, the central midfielders. I put Aron Gunnarsson as a centre midfielder defend, because he sits a bit deeper than Gylfi Sigurðsson. Sigurðsson he goes forward and supports the strikers and midfielders attack, and he also supports the winners, and you come back and defend with Gunnarsson. So that's why I put him as an automatic. So for me, that's a perfect role and perfect position for me. Well, I put Göran Bergmansson as a wide midfielder attack. I put him on attack duty because he loves to attack. He's not really a wide midfielder. He's more of a winger. He loves to attack and put crosses in, cut inside, take shots. So instead of doing that, I put him as a wide midfielder attack. And then I put Birgir Bjarnason. He's more of a centre midfielder, but he plays out wide. So I put him as a wide midfielder on automatic duty, up and down the flank, having to have all the responsibilities coming back in defence. I sit really on the positions. Right, the mentality. I put counter because Arsenal love to sit deep and play high tempo and counter. I had structure because they play very compact and very organised as a group. Finally, onto the instructions here. I put deeper because Arsenal loves to sit deep, very deep, near the penalty area. Onto the tempo. I put higher tempo because they play hard tempo on the counter, which is basically how they score. With narrow, I put narrow because they're very compact and like I put a defensive block. So I put narrow. Closing down, I didn't put anything because they press only sometimes. And as you can see, as you know, they play direct and they're very disciplined. Right, now let's watch a few clips from each game and see how it went. Right, as you can see, Iceland building up from the back. Not really building up from the back, but like, as you can see, they play through the middle a bit and they push the ball out wide, and then Sigurðsson tucks it home. That's how Iceland kind of score their goals. See, they win the ball back after Portugal being blunt in attack. See, Sigurðsson tucks it home again. See, this is Portugal having in possession here. Iceland with a defensive block. Iceland keeping solid. Which is the way they have been throughout the year 2016. So as you can see here, Portugal can't break through Iceland here. I mean, Bernardo here has no choice other than do a pointless shot. See? Again, Arsenal win the ball. I mean, Portugal pretty much blunt in possession. They can't really do anything because of Arsenal's solid, compact defensive block. As you can see here, this is how Arsenal set up. Look how narrow they are. I mean, they win the ball back. Even though Arsenal is not very good at keeping the ball, but it shows that Portugal can't really do much on the ball. And how solid Arsenal block is. Defensive block, sorry. See, this is pretty much what it was like in the Euro 2016. Right. This is how Iceland kind of played against England. I was on to Parson, and well, you see, they play through the middle a bit, and then they spread the ball wide to the fullbacks, and then they do some 1-2s, and then they spread it out wide again. See, Gudmundsson nearly scored. See, this is the type of football they played against England. See, this is how Arsenal scored, by playing on counter, high tempo. And as you can see, Arsenal's shape here, Sigurdsson presses more than Gunnarsson. Alright, this is how Arsenal scored against Austria. They played in a high counter, through the middle, spread it out wide. And then pass back, and then pass it back out wide to your fullbacks. See, this gives you an idea.